ಪರಾಂಧಸ್ಯ ಜ್ಞಾನಾಂಜನ ಶಲಾಕಯ ಚಕ್ಷುರುನ್ಮಿಲಿತಂ ಯೇನ ತಸ್ಮೈ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುವೇ ನಮಃ. ನಮಃ ಓಂ ವಿಷ್ಣುಪದಾಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣಪ್ರೇಷ್ಠಾಯ ಭೂತಲೆ ಶ್ರೀಮತೆ ಭಕ್ತಿದಾಂತ ಸ್ವಾಮೀಜಿ ನಾಮ ನಮಸ್ತೆ. ಸರಸ್ವತೀ ದೇವಿ ಗೌರವಾಣಿ ಪ್ರಚಾರಣೆ ನಿರ್ವಿಶೇಷಾ ಶೂನ್ಯವಾದಿ ಪಾಶ್ಚಾತ್ಯ ಜಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಪ್ರಭು ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಶ್ರೀ ಅದ್ವೈತ ಗದಾಧರ ಶ್ರೀವಾಸಾದಿ ಗೌರವ ಭಕ್ತವೃಂದ. ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ ಹರೇ, ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ ಹರೇ, ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ ಹರೇ, ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ ಹರೇ. ಟುಡೇ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಫಾಲ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈನ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸಫರಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈನ್, ಬಟ್ ಯು ಡು ನಾಟ್ ನೋ ಹೌ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ರೈನ್. We are of course making arrangements to feed the poor on account of scarcity of rain. That's all right, you are doing, but if there is no rain, how long you will go on with this philanthropy work? That is our question. How long, what stock you have got in your store so that you can continually, you can go on? What is the answer? You must have rain and produce grain. Now you have got some stock of rain. You are distributing, that's all right. You have got money, that's all right. But when there will be all stock finished and still there is no grain, what you will do? Because rain is not in your hand. Rain is not in your hand. It is in higher authorities. So what you will do? But the process is given there in the Bhagavad Gita. ಯಜ್ಞಾತ್ ಭವತಿ ಪರ್ಜನ್ಯೋ ಪ್ರಜನ್ಯಾದನ್ನ ಸಂಭವ ಯಜ್ಞ, ಬಟ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಯಜ್ಞ. ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಎ ವಾವ್, ನೋ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಎನಿ ಯಜ್ಞ. ವಿ ಆರ್ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಯಜ್ಞ. ಯಜ್ಞ ನಾಟ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಮನಿ. ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಸಂಕೀರ್ತನ ಯಜ್ಞ. ಯಜ್ಞೈ ಸಂಕೀರ್ತನ ಪ್ರಾಯೇ ರಜಂತಿ ಸುಮೇಧಸಃ. ಶ್ರೀಮದ್ ಭಾಗವತಂ 11.5.32. Simply chanting, you are distributing food, that's all right. Why not allow them to chant Hare Krishna mantra? What is the loss? But they will not accept it. They will not accept it. This is the dox, obstinacy against Krishna consciousness. But they cannot answer. Just suppose if your stock of grain is finished, then what you will do? If there is no rain, you cannot produce rain in your factory. Rain or grain or anything in your factory or mill, that is not possible. This is taken from the Nectar of Instruction, Nectar of Devotion lecture by A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, the founder Acharya of International Society for Krishna Consciousness at Bombay, January 8, 1973. So mostly we will be reading from Prabhupada's books, lectures, conversations. Another conversation during morning walk, June 2, 1974, Geneva. Prabhupada: dry means there is no rain. If nature likes, there can be profuse rain. That is nature's arrangement. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Parjanyat anda sambhavah. Parjanyat. You must have sufficient rain. And for having sufficient rain, you must execute yagna. Yagnat bhavati parjanyah. 3.14 Bhagavad Gita. So these people are now becoming rascals. They are not performing yagna. They are opening slaughterhouse. How they will be rain? Instead of performing yagna, they are opening big slaughterhouse. I think now in many parts of the world, the desert is increasing. Yes, desert will increase. Yogeshwara: so under the present condition, it's necessary to transfer food at least for the time being. We don't have the possibility of growing food anywhere and everywhere. So some transportation of food is required. Prabhupada: where do you get for transportation if there is no grain? If you say there is no hope of producing food grain, then where is the chance of transportation? Where in some areas there is. In somewhere, if somewhere is produced, Prabhupada, in somewhere, if somewhere it is produced, then that the other place also can be produced. You perform yagna, sankirtana yagna, you will get enough food. Yagna bhavati parjanyaha, parjanyadanna sambhavaha. annad bhavanti bhutani pavatita 3.14. So in Switzerland there are many starter houses also, many, yes. Guru Gauranga, some time ago I read in the papers that they had so much milk and so much butter that the government proposal was kill the cows. Prabhupada, kill all the animals, oh Jesse, they will not give to others. The Bhagavan, the farmers were complaining that their prices weren't competitive because there was so much milk. Prabhupada, the price is the standard, not that goods are required. They want money for purchasing wine. This is the difficult. They are not satisfied simply by eating sufficient. They want money for women and wine. This is their philosophy. Bhagavan, in the United States, the same problem was there and the prices were all going up. Everything was having inflation. So if they had sense, they should have exported where there is a necessity of this milk, butter, grain, then the world will be happy. That Yogeshwara, that was my question. If there is necessity for exporting, then there is necessity for maintaining ships and trains and means of communication, employing workers, electrical dynamos for running. Prabhupada, no point is if in the one place you can produce food, grains, butter and milk, why not other place? That is my point. The land is everywhere the same, if one place. Now here in Europe and America there is enough production because the population is less. So the whole America is bigger than India at least 4 times and the population is not even half. What is the population of all America? Bhagavan, 20 crores and India, 60 crores. And just see, and the land is 4 times more than India at least. Therefore, you find excess. You see, otherwise India is also producing. No, India is not producing. It is not utilizing all the land. Guru Gauranga, if the people here are so sinful, how it is that they have so many nice facilities, it will go on away soon. As soon as they increase their sinful activities, these facilities will be taken away. Therefore, we propose that everything belongs to Krishna and we are all sons of Krishna. Just cooperate in Krishna consciousness, then the whole world will be happy. This is our proposal. Why do you think it is American, it is Swiss, it is Indian? Everything belongs to Krishna. Let us become obedient to Krishna and because we are sons of Krishna, let us enjoy the property of Krishna. Immediately there will be happiness. I have several times said that still the whole world can produce so much grains and foodstuffs 10 times the population can feed 10 times in Africa, in Australia and even in America so much. I mean prospect of producing food. But they will not cooperate. They will kill all the animal. They will throw the grain to the sea and claim it is my land, it is my property. Bhagavan, then they complain about scarcity. Prabhupada, for money. So rascal civilization is going on. Therefore I challenge that man, where is your brain? There is no brain. You remember that? Yogeshwara, from the International Labour Organization, Prabhupada, yes, there is no brain. Karandara, Prabhupada, in recent study by US agricultural officials, they found that it is really economical to eat meat. It takes so much energy and man hours to raise and transport and slaughter the cows that it makes it very wasteful. Prabhupada, wasteful, yes. Therefore, I say they have no brain. All they are rascals, rascal leaders. A little labour in agriculture will be sufficient to produce a family's food stock for the whole year. You can stock. You work only 3 months and you get sufficient food for your whole family and unless 9 months you chant Hare Krishna, but these rascals will not do that. They will work hard like simply for eating. Yunam Pramatta Kurute Vikarmayat Indriya Prite Apranoti Srimad Bhagavatam 5.5.4. They will not accept easy life. Guru Gauranga, in the agricultural department report, it is said that if they were to eat all the grains that they give to the cows and animals, they could get 20 times more calories than by eating meat. Prabhupada, yes, wrong civilization, rascal civilization. And this is due to this rascaldom, nationalism. This is my land and at any moment he will be kicked out. Still he claims, it is my land. Aham mameti janasya mohoyam aham mameti. 5.5.8. This is the illusion. Nothing belongs to him. Still he is fighting. This is mine. This is mine. I and mine. Identifying himself with the body. With this body. I and wrongly conceiving that this is mine. This is the basic principle of wrong civilization. Both things are. Nothing belongs to him. Suppose I have come here in Switzerland. If I remain here for 1 month and claim. And I claim, oh, this is mine. What is this? So similarly, I come as a guest. Everyone comes as guest in the womb of his mother and lives here for 50 years, he is claiming it is mine. When it becomes yours, the land was long time before your birth. How it became yours, but they have no sense. It is mine. Fight. My land, my nation, my family, my society. This way wasting time. These things have been introduced by these Western Vaidyas. In the Vedic civilization, there is no such thing as nationalism. You won't find, have you seen in the Bhagavad Gita any word nationalism? No such thing. This is the original ideas of the tribes. Jungle there is, just like in Africa there are still groups of tribes. This is most crude idea of civilization, nationalism. This is tribalized. It is nothing but development of just tribalism. Eating also the same. They are not advanced in civilization. This nationalism is another form of tribalism, that's all. Bhagavan, they are actually just cannibals because they maintain themselves on eating the cow. Prabhupada, yes. Bhagavan, yes, they think it's so horrible to eat another person, but yes. Yes, and they're suffering. Therefore, you'll find in the recent history, every 25 years there is big war, slaughter, mass slaughtering of the people. How nature will tolerate? Now, India has learned, imitated the Western countries. Now, there is war between India and Pakistan. Otherwise, there was no such thing. During two wars between the Pakistan and Hindustan, unnecessarily, without any profit, millions of people were killed. Karandara, just recently, India exploded an atomic bomb and now Pakistan is hurrying to get an atomic bomb also. Prabhupada, yes, this is going on. Guru Gauranga, the government promised it would be only for peaceful purposes. Prabhupada, no. What do they know about peaceful conditions? They are all rascals. They do not know what is peaceful condition. Actually, peaceful condition is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Voktaram Vyagnatapasam Sarvalokamaheshwaram Suradam Sarva Bhutanam Gyatva Mam Shanti Ruchati Bhagavad Gita 5.29. This is peace. Unless there is Krishna consciousness, where is the peacefulness? It cannot be. All rascaldom. Moodha. Namam Dushkritino Moodha Prabhadyante Naradamaha Bhagavad Gita 7.15. These rascals and fools. Mayaya Apakrita Jnanaha. Lost of all knowledge. How there can be peace? Is it all useless? What is this? Now we will go to another Bhagavad Gita lecture. Bhagavad Gita 3.16-17, New York, May 25, 1966. Now pasturing ground for the cows. The grass is produced by rains. And animals, they eat the grass and they produce milk. You require milk. So everything, the main source of supply is the rainfall from the sky. That is not under your control. So Bhagavad Gita says, Parjanya Danna Sambhavaha. Without rain, you cannot have any production. Nothing can be produced without rain. And without production, you cannot live. But rain, regular rain, and regulative rain and useful rain will fall when you perform sacrifices. Yagna, yagna bhavati parjanyaha, Bhagavad Gita 3.14. And yagna karma samudbhavaha, and you can perform yagna by working. Because yagna requires material, so if you have no money, if you don't work, you cannot have money. So everything is a circle, is nice circle. Karma brahmodbhavam, and how to work, that is described in the Vedic Nation, that you should work like this we have all discussed. Niyatam kuru karma tvam karma jyayohi akarmanaha. So everyone has prescribed duties. There are different classes of men. The intelligent class of men, the administrative class of men, the productive class of men, the laborer class of men. Everyone has to work. And by working, by the result of the work, one has to perform yagna. And by regular performance of yagna, there will be regular rains. And by regular rains, there will be production sufficient to supply performance of yagna. There will be regular rains. And by regular rains, there will be production sufficient to supply your necessary supply. And that is a circle. That is a circle. So anyway, one has to work sincerely his prescribed duties, and by the result of such work, one has to offer sacrifices to please the Supreme Lord. That is the circle. And Lord Krishna says, evam pravartitam chakram. Now this circle, this moving the circle, just like the potter moves the circle to make production, you have seen similarly, we have to move the circle. Circle means it is moving, meant for moving. is another Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, 10th chapter, 4th verse, London, New York 25, 1973, Prabhupada's lecture. Therefore, there must be some regulatory principle to fulfill our desire. And how the regulatory principles come to be fulfilled? Here it is said, Kamam Vivarsha Parjanyaha, Srimad Bhagavatam 1.10.4. Vivarsha means showering, and Parjanyaha means rain. Parjanyaha is rain. So, our all needs are showered from up. Therefore we pray, Eko yo bahunam vidadhati kaman. God, rain is not under your control. Rain, it comes from sky, through the clouds. It is not under your control. When there is scarcity of rain, it is not your so-called science can produce rain. No, that is not possible. Drought, so many places. Last 2 years, so kamam, our spiritual life. From material point of view, it is fulfilled by rainfall from the sky. There is no rainfall, you cannot produce anything. Kamam Bavarsha. This is the description during the reign of Maharaja Parikshita, Maharaja Yudhishthira. Maharaja Yudhishthira was the king of this earth. And he was so pious on account of his prayer, his piety. Krishna supplied everything sumptuously. Now have you ever experienced, now here it is stated, Sishuchuhu Smarajan Gavaha. Now we are anchoring after milk, but in those days during Maharaja Yudhishthira's time, milk was so sufficiently produced that before milking the cow, it supplied milk so sufficiently that what is called grazing ground, pasturing ground, they become muddy with milk. Now with the scarcity of grain, the earth also does not become muddy. It becomes dry earth. But in those days with milk it was muddy. Just imagine how much milk was, how it is possible. Sishchuho smavrajan gavaha prayo payo soda swatir muda, Srimad Bhagavatam 1.1. The milk bag was so fatty and full with milk. Why? Muda. They were so happy. If you keep the cows happy, the cow will supply large quantity of milk. If the cow knows that you are going to kill it, she is always afraid, always fearful. Oh, this man will kill. They can understand. I have seen in New Vrindavan, one cow, she was crying because her calf was taken away. So she was feeling so sorry. Now in our New Vrindavan, we see how the cows are happy, how they are dealing. They are not afraid. This is our duty, to keep the cows happy. Just like I want to see my wife and children happy, similarly, it is the duty of the human society to see that the cows feeling very happy. This is human civilization. Otherwise, it is tiger civilization, meat eaters. Meat is not eaten by human beings. It is eaten by the dogs, by the tigers, by the animals. So we have created a society for killing cows and eating the meat and maintaining slaughterhouse in the name of religion. This is going on. So how can we be happy? There cannot be happiness. It is not a sentiment. Therefore, this is most sinful activity. Meat eating, cow killing, most sinful activity. And you have to suffer for it. Unfortunately, these rascals, they do not know that what is the result of this sinful activity. They think the life will go on and there is no more life. After finishing of this body, everything will be finished. Atheistic theory. Basma bhutasya dehasya. Basmi bhutasya dehasya. Kuta punaragamo bhavet kutaha. Ho, who is coming? But that they do not know, rascals. We get information from Krishna, Tata Dehantara Praptihi. Okay, 2.13. Oh, you have to accept another body after finishing this body. But they are not responsible. So they are irresponsible. So they do not care for the next life. The result of gross and pious and sinful activities. So it appears that how much strictly the cow protection was there, so that the gavaha payosada swathir mudha, you will see Krishna is always with cows, and how the cows look very happy with Krishna, and Krishna is personally teaching how to protect cows. He became a covered boy. He was king's son, Maharajananda, but his business was to take the cows and the calves daily to the pasturing ground, and it was very sportive engagement with the covered boys. The cows were grazing and the boys, they took their meals in a pot, tiffin carrier in those days, some other, and they used to eat them. distribute among the friends. Sometimes the tiffin carrier was stolen by one boy and he was searching, and then it was so just like the boys too. This was the children's life, to take protection, to give protection to the cows. The small children up to 6 years, 7 years old, they used to take care of the cows, and the elderly men, they used to take care of the elderly boys, they used to take care of the grown-up cows. So the cows were fed very nicely. Vrajan, therefore Vrindavana is called Vrajabhumi, where there are many cows. It is called Gokula. Gokula, go means cows, and Kula means group. Gokula, Govardhana hill, because the cows were grazing on the hill and profuse grass was being grown and they are enjoying, so there should be arrangement. That's like here we see there are so many open fields and the cows are grazing, but they cannot be happy because they know that they are simply raised for being killed. They cannot be happy. Our Krishna consciousness movement is not a sentimental movement. It takes care of all found social organization. It is not something like religious sentiment. Everything should be taken care of. Therefore, we say cow protection. Cow protection. Here it is said, Kamam bavarsha parjanyaha sarva kama duga mahi. Mahi means land. Bhagavatam 1.10.4. Bhumir agnir mahi gagam ambu maruddhishas mahi. That is a mahi. Srimad Bhagavad Gita lecture 1.8.19, Mayapur, September 28, 1974. What Krishna says that is practical. Anna davatipur bhutani parjanyat anna sambhavaha. How we shall greet the rain? Anna, there is no rain. You see, nowadays there is no rain. Why? Because we are all rascals. We do not know how to get rain. Like Krishna says, parjanyat anna sambhavaha. There will be food grains when there is sufficient rain. And how rain there will be? Yagna bhavati parjanyaha. And if you perform yagna, then there will be sufficient rain. So nowadays you people may say, how to perform yagna? It requires so much money, so much ghee, so much food grains to offer as oblation. But Krishna has made it very easy. Yagnai sankirtana praye rajanti hi sumedasaha. Srimad Bhagavatam 11.5.32. Yagnaihi sankirtana prayaihi. I know, the Shastras know that in the Kali Yuga, it will be very difficult to perform the ritualistic yagna ceremony because people will be poor, poverty stricken, when they will be, where they will get ghee and where they will get grains. No, this is yagna. Kalau nasteva 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 gatir anyatha. Harer nama harer nama harer nama iva kevalam. Chaitanya Charitamrita Adilila 17.21. This is yagna. So people are so rascal, they will not even chant Hare Krishna Mantra. Krishna, Swayam Bhagavan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu introduced Sankirtana. Sankirtanaika Pitaro Gaura Nityananda is the father of the Sankirtana movement. Therefore, Vrindavana Dasa Thakura has offered this prayer. Sankirtanaika Pitaro Ajanalambita Bhujo Lokanana Kanakavadhatu Sankirtanaika Pitaro Kamalaya Taksho Vande Mahapurushate Charanaravindam. So Krishna is teaching. Krishna is so kind, he is personally teaching. That is perform yagna. He is personally chanting, dancing, Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The picture is in our front. Personally he is teaching us, perform this yagna, you rascal, and you will get everything. You will get everything. Now, where is the proof? The proof is Krishna consciousness movement. We are simply chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra and spending crores of rupees. Simply, we are not doing any business. We have not many professional men. But why we are getting? We are spending 8 lakhs of rupees per month and we have got food, we have got milk, we are rather feeding others also, bringing food. So why don't you see practically how these Krishna conscious people, they know that we are fabulously rich. This question was raised in parliament also. So how we become fabulously rich? who do not do anything. I have not taught you anything magic. I simply request to chant Hare Krishna 16 times, please. But you are not even following that. This is the only remedy. Yagnai Sankirtana Prairajanti Sumedasaha. So Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Ishvara is teaching us this yagna, is giving us the hint, yagna bhavati parjanyaha. If you do not accept this moment, then you will go on suffering. If you don't accept this principle, then your future is simply suffering. Prayena alpa aishuhu sabhyaha kalau asmin yuge janaha mandasu mandamatayo mandavagya hipadritaha. This is a symptom of Kali Yuga, mandabhagya, all unfortunate. Everyone must suffer. This is the position. But if you chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, perform the Yagna, because this is an instruction by the Supreme Person, Purusham Tvame Adhyam Purusham, the original person, the origin of everything, Janma Dasya Ataha, Supreme Person from whom has everything come down. That is the order. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught us that Hare Rama Iva Kevalam. We are certainly in difficult position, but the only remedy is that we must chant the holy name of the Lord repeatedly, and that will solve all the problems. You preach this cult all over the world. So Krishna is the original person. He has admitted, and Shastra admits, and there is another authority, Kunti, the mother of Pandavas.